diabetes means sugar in the blood. It actually has to do with the journey of our food. Carbohydrates are your number one fuel for energy. Carbohydrates and all of our food, we take in, we digest, and then eventually they hit our bloodstream. In our bloodstream, what was once this large chunk of food is now these tiny pieces. So carbs turn into glucose, and glucose are in your bloodstream waiting for a ride into your cells. The only way that glucose can get into your cells is through a ride with insulin. And insulin is made in your pancreas. So the pancreas releases insulin, it picks up that glucose, and it takes it to the cells to be converted to energy. So it's a long journey that our food turns into energy. Diabetes means sugar in the blood. So for some reason, that sugar is still in your bloodstream, which is a problem with our pancreas, not so much about what we're eating. Our pancreas's main job is to produce insulin. It's a little factory that makes insulin, releases that insulin into your bloodstream, and helps that glucose get into your cells, where it's finally energy for your body. Energy to make your body move, think, breathe. Everything works off of glucose. So sometimes our pancreas will stop working. The factory will either completely shut down or it will take a little break, kind of like an early retirement or go on part-time. So we have different types of diabetes. There's gestational diabetes that can happen when a woman is pregnant. The pregnancy can cause too much stress on the pancreas and the pancreas can take a break for the next 9 months. Or we have type 1 diabetes, which is less common. Usually is diagnosed in kiddos between 9 and ages 15, but it can happen at any time in life. It's an autoimmune attack that causes the factory to be shut down and no longer produce insulin. Then we have type 2 diabetes, which is much more common, but we don't always know what causes it. We do know that lifestyle and genetics can play a role, and sometimes changing the way we eat, or maybe becoming more active, and the inclusion of medicine can help our pancreas work better, thus reducing complications. The problem with diabetes is that we don't always feel bad, but our pancreas may be stressed and not working like it should, which means the sugar in our bloodstream is continuing to rise. Diabetes is a lot more manageable now because we know so much more about it. Diabetes has been around for thousands and thousands of years, but just in the last 100 years have we had insulin. We now have the ability to give a person insulin and prolong their life. In the last 30 years, we've had more improvements in medications. We now have many types of insulin that are more manageable for a person with diabetes, and we have oral medications and injectables that can help a person with type 2 diabetes live a long and healthy life. Medications are used to help manage diabetes in different ways. A person with type 1 will need insulin from day 1 to the end of their life. A person with type 2 might need different kinds of medications with time. And just because you have type 2 diabetes or your friend has type 2 diabetes, you might manage your diabetes with different medications. There are some oral medications that help the pancreas work better, and there are some oral medications that help other organs in the body work better to help you feel better and live a long, healthy life. The body will send off different signals to let you know that something is wrong. Since we're not converting food into energy, the person will start to feel really hungry, thirsty, tired because they're not receiving any energy. Sometimes their vision will change. Sometimes they may go to the bathroom a lot, or sometimes they might be irritable or cranky. We might also see a sudden weight loss because since your body is not able to convert glucose into energy from carbohydrates, your body then breaks down the stores from your body's protein and fat stores. So we see a rapid weight loss, which may be encouraging, but is actually a sign that something's wrong. If you feel that you might have diabetes or you have these signs or symptoms, it's important to talk to your doctor. Ask questions. Find out what your fasting blood sugar is or what your A1C is, the last 3 months of your blood sugar. It's important to get a hand on managing your diabetes, which can be done successfully to prevent complications. Management includes lifestyle, by being mindful of what you're eating, moving your body, listening to how you're taking care of your body, how you're coping and solving problems, and how you're reducing risks.